Today on The Morning Show, are you faster than normal? How Peter Shankman harnessed his ADD to become a successful entrepreneur.
But up next, how Peter Shankman harnessed his attention deficit order to begin a successful career in business, and what everyone can do to maximize productivity.
Okay, question. Are you a Lamborghini with bicycle brakes? That's how Dr. Peter Shankman describes a person with a mind that's been affected by ADHD.
And in his new book, Faster Than Normal, Shankman reveals how you can harness your energy and direct your focus to find success in your personal life and career. And Dr. Peter Shankman joins us now. In fact, you credit ADHD for your success.
I do. The majority of what I've done, I've started and sold three companies. I'm an Ironman triathlete. I have a four-year-old daughter. You know, all these things that I spend the majority of my time running around, about 200 miles an hour. But I think that is, you know, the stuff that they used to get in trouble for in school is now tremendously benefiting me.
Well, I was going to ask you, so is it like a bit of a mind shift or a different way of looking at things for people when it comes to ADHD?
When I was growing up, ADHD didn't exist. In the public schools in New York City, it was sit down, you're disrupting the class disease, right? And over time, I realized that the benefit of my having ADHD, I have two speeds. I have, you know, namaste, and I have, I'll cut someone. You know, there's no middle ground there. And so the beauty of that is that, you know, I think of an idea, yeah, this might be an interesting company, and an hour and a half later I've started it. You know, I don't have that sort of processing time. And that's very beneficial in business and in life, but, you know, unless you're following certain rules, it can also be very detrimental.
Sure.
How do you control something that's so uncontrollable?
Well, it really is. It's, you know, if you give someone a Lamborghini and you say, hey, you've been driving a Honda all your life, here's a Lamborghini, enjoy it. Unless they know how to drive it, they're going to get behind the wheel and, you know, smack it into a tree. So the key really is to have these sort of life rules that I call them. I don't start my day without exercise, right? And sometimes that means getting up as early as 3:45 in the morning, 4 a.m., because I have to. Exercise settles my brain. It gives me the dopamine and the serotonin that people with ADHD don't have. It gives me enough of that to sort of focus and get through my day. I eliminate choice. I have two sides to my closet. They're labeled, literally labeled, office and travel, and it's a t-shirt and jeans, and speaking/TV, which is something like this. And there's no middle ground. You know, if I had everything else there, it would be, you know, oh, that sweater. I remember that sweater. Laura gave me that sweater. I wonder how I should look her up. It's 3 hours later. I'm naked in the living room on Facebook. I haven't left the house, right? Yeah. So you eliminate the things that can cause that distraction. I eat at certain times. I have, it's called intermittent fasting, right? I eat between 2 p.m. and 8 p.m. So if I'm walking to the office and say, oh, I really want a bagel or a donut. Nope, can't.
You know, everything you're describing here, Peter, honestly, is the way that I live my life, and I don't have ADHD. I used to exercise early in the morning, yeah. But with this shift,
obviously,
you can't.
Yeah.
I do it later in the
right.
day, but same thing when it comes to clothing, like the simpler, the better. Mm-hmm. Just take out all of the choice. It speeds up the process in the morning.
Well, and that's really the beauty of the book. You know, I wrote the book with the premise that I would help people with ADHD, and between the book and my podcast, also called Faster Than Normal, we've done that. But what I realized after the book was published is that I started getting emails from regular people. Said, oh my God, I've gotten 3 hours of my day back. You know, I'm so much more productive. I might have ADHD. No, you're just putting priorities onto what's important.
Yeah, so these are great life rules
exactly.
for anyone.
Exactly.
Right?
Okay, but now along with the labeling and the structuring, you've also skydived a number of times. How many times?
I have just under 500 jumps.
Yes. So, and that's a form of self-medication as well, you've said. Mm-hmm. So do you recommend this for everyone?
You know, I recommend finding what works for you. You know, for me, it was skydiving, and I didn't realize it was skydiving until I did my first jump with a bunch of friends. And, you know, my friends were all like, wow, that's really cool. I could check that off my list. I'm like, I need to do that again. You know, I have friends that I ran a 5K with them. We're like, that was really fun. Let's check that off my list. I have to do an Ironman. You know, it's there are things that but again, it's the opposite of that is, you know, not finding positive things and finding negative things. Drug abuse. There's an estimate that up to 40% of people incarcerated in the United States have undiagnosed ADHD, right? So if you understand your brain and you understand sort of ADHD is when you're looking around for, you know, squirrel or whatever it is. What you're looking for is something to keep you excited, something to keep that dopamine flowing the same way for normal people that it just regularly happens.
What is it, though, that skydiving does for you? That it's, it sent you back nearly 500 times.
When you're jumping out of a plane, your brain is screaming at you. You're in the plane, the door is open, you're looking down at the ground, your brain, you don't have to do this. Your brain is literally saying, this plane can land on its own, probably. You know, you don't have to do this. And so you're taking everything out of your system and saying, I want to do this anyway. Once you trip that, and you sort of trip that switch, your brain says, okay, then we need to make sure that he focuses and focuses and focuses, because with our luck, you know, he'll be about to pull his parachute open, and ooh, the sun, it's so bright. Yeah. So let's focus on everything. So it releases every single drop of dopamine, serotonin, and adrenaline that my brain has. It's producing extra. The problem is when you land, that doesn't just go away. So when I land, I take off my parachute, I'm essentially high. I take off my parachute, I grab my laptop, I'll write 10,000 words in an hour. I'll write literally 4 chapters of my next book in an hour. I'll hyper-focus.
If I did that, I'd be kissing the ground. Thank you.
It's hyper-focus. Yeah. It's all about hyper-focus.
Fascinating stuff. Peter Shankman. The book is Faster Than Normal. Thank you so much for coming in.
My pleasure. Thank you.